Now we will move to the second method, okay, which is using the exponentials. So let me write here. So the second method is also an exact method. So exact method 2. Exact method 2. So in this exact method 2, we will use the exponential relations of cos h gamma l and sin h gamma l to find their values. So cos h gamma l exponential equivalent is e power gamma l plus e power minus gamma l by 2. E power gamma l plus e power minus gamma l by 2. What is actually gamma l? Gamma l is alpha l plus j beta l. Now cos h gamma l is equal to substituting alpha l plus j beta l in place of gamma l, you will get this as e power alpha l into e power j beta l plus, and it is minus gamma l, so you will get e power minus alpha l into e power minus j beta l total divided with. Now, e power j theta can be considered as angle theta, because e power I theta can be written as cos theta plus I sin theta. Cos theta plus I sin theta is nothing but angle theta. Hence, e power j beta l can be considered as angle beta l. E power minus j beta l can be considered as angle minus beta l. Hence, you will get cos h gamma l value as summation of e power alpha l at an angle of beta l and e power minus alpha l at an angle minus beta l total divided with 2. But here let me write one thing which you need to keep in your mind. So one thing which we need to keep in our mind, so let me write the note here. You need to substitute beta l in degrees. Actually we got alpha l and beta l in radians, but here you need to substitute beta l in degrees in order to get cos h gamma l. This is the simple thing which we need to keep in your mind, and it is also an important thing. Okay, now what is alpha l and beta l in radians which we got in the previous page? Let me see that. So these are the two values of alpha l and beta l. Okay, alpha l is 0.0558. Let me write here, alpha l is 0.0558 and beta l value is 0.3578 radians. This is in radians and this is also in radians. But as we need to substitute this in terms of an angle, I need to convert that into degrees. Okay. So how can you convert this into degrees? By multiplying with 180 and dividing with pi. You will get 0.3578 into 180 divided by pi degrees. In radians, the value is 0.3578. In degrees, it will become 20.5 degrees. So this is beta L value in degrees, and alpha L value can be in radians. But beta L value must be in degrees in order to substitute in the expansion of cos h gamma l. Now find cos h gamma l by substituting these things. What is e power alpha l? It is e power 0.0558 at an angle 20.5 degrees plus e power minus 0.0558 at an angle minus 20.5 degrees divided by 2. Now what is this value? If you evaluate this with the help of calculator, cos h gamma l value will be 0.9378 at an angle 1.1982 degrees. Okay, when you compare this cos h gamma l value, which we found by using this second method, with the first method, what is cos h gamma l we got using the first method? It is 0.9383 at an angle 1.2 degrees. Here it is 0.9378 at an angle 1.198, is nothing but almost 1.2 degrees, and there is no much difference between 0.938 and 0.937. So that's why these two methods will give the same result. Okay, it depends on your comfort while attempting the question in the examination. It depends upon your comfort. You can choose the method. Now, how can I find sin h gamma l? If you keep the negative sign here, you will get sin h gamma l. Is it right or not? So that's the reason why I am directly substituting the things in sin h gamma l without writing all the things again. So e power 0.0558 at an angle 20.5 minus e power minus 0.0558 at an angle minus 20.5 degrees, whole divided by 2. Okay, so here you got plus and here you will get minus. This is the only difference between sin h gamma l and cos h gamma l values. If you find this value, it comes out to be 0.3544 at an angle 81.49. So this is the sin h gamma l value and cos h gamma l value using the second method. Now you can observe that second method is very easy when compared to first method. Both are exact methods. When compared to first method, second method of finding cos h gamma l and sin h gamma l value is easy, right? Now let me write cos h gamma l and sin h gamma l values which are found in the previous method here. So the black color indicates the second method values, whereas the red color indicates the first method values. If you see these two values, you can observe that there is no difference, there is no much difference present in these two values. Okay, here also there is no much difference present in these two values. Now substitute these two things in this equation like this here. As in place of cos h gamma l, we substituted this value. Now by substituting these values in the same places, you will get sending end voltage Vs as, okay, I am not substituting all the things again, okay, it is the task for you. So if you substitute Vr, Ir and sin h gamma l and cos h gamma l values which we got just now, these are the two values which we got just now, and these are the two values which we got from the first method. As there is no much difference between these two values, I am not substituting everything. I am just writing the values. So we will get this as 136.978.4 at an angle 6.2 degrees, and IS value which you will get here when you substitute the things, you will get this as 128.89 at an angle 15.56 degrees. Okay, so these are the two values which we got by using exact method 2. Let me write the values which we got by using exact method 1. exact method 1. So we got VS value as 137,045.3 at an angle 6.2 and IS value as 128.91 at an angle 15.57 degrees. So these are the values which we got by applying the exact method 1. So here we got 136.9 kilovolts, here we got 137.04 kilovolts. If you observe, there is no much difference between these two. Angle we got the same value, and here we got 15.56 degrees, 15.57 degrees, both are same, and 128.8, 128.9. So there is no much difference you can observe either by you applying exact method 1 and exact method 2. You can apply any method, it depends upon your comfort, it depends upon your way of understanding the problem. Okay, so this is about the second method.